Hi, welcome to our Hackaday Prize project, Hacker Calculus. Calculus is a study of how things move, how things change, and we think it's buried in way too much algebra. So what we're doing in this project is using some electronics that you can build, some 3D prints that you can create, and some concepts that you can learn calculus just by making things or at least get started. So I'm Joan Horvath.
I'm Rich Cameron.
And the two of us are in Nonscriptum LLC. We teach people things. The first thing we're going to talk about is what's called the fundamental theorem of calculus. And it occurred to Isaac Newton in the middle 1600s. And basically, it goes like this. We have a curve, like x cubed here. The slope of it, how much it changes, otherwise known as its derivative, is x squared. But the interesting thing is if we have the curve x squared, the area underneath it, otherwise known as the integral under it, goes as x cubed. Something else that we can do with a 3D printer really pretty uniquely is actually print something three-dimensional. And so in this case, we're showing a three-dimensional result of two differential equations about how predator and prey vary over time as one eats the other. And so in this case, we have three axes. We have prey going that way. We have predators going that way, and we have time going along the bottom. And so we can look at three different projections. We can look at that way, which shows us one of the axes. We can turn it that way, which shows us another. And then we can turn it end on, which shows us basically integrating over time. So there aren't a lot of other really good ways to explore two equations in three unknowns this way other than 3D printing. The next concept we'll talk about is the idea of a limit. Isaac Newton realized if you have a mathematical surface, you can approximate it with a series of boxes or straight lines. The approximation gets better and better as the boxes get smaller. This is obvious when you create the surface and approximate it with some real boxes, but when you teach it traditionally, it can get lost in the algebra. We want our project to make concepts like this much more accessible by people who learn by touching things or, in fact, by making things. Next, we want to try modeling a real system, a PID controller. These are used to keep a measured quantity like temperature close to a desired level. Here's a model of the information used by a controller. Time goes from left to right. And we're modeling all the information the controller uses to calculate how it should adjust what it's controlling. In the front, we see a constant error signal, followed by a model of the signal, a term proportional to the signal, and then the signal's integral and derivative. This is a system that goes to a stable state, again, with time going across from left to right. Creating models like this can allow us to visualize more complicated equations like this one that oscillates. And again, we can allow people who prefer to or need to learn by examining a physical object learn more efficiently.
Accelerometers, like the one on Circuit Playground, read the sum of the gravity and acceleration vectors. This device shows the direction of the combined vector and turns green if the magnitude is zero in x and y. We printed a case to hold the Circuit Playground and battery pack for mobile experiments, like showing that acceleration and gravity cancel out for objects in freefall.
Now we have to stop and think where we'll take our project next. It's become clear to us that calculus needs to be taught in a very different order to take advantage of our models. We're thinking about how to scale this and take it in more directions. Can we usefully go beyond the PID example, in which everything's a function of time, to some more complex systems in which several things are varying at once? Can we use these parts to help us think about differential equations? Or should we be looking at how to start with these ideas and move back the other direction toward geometry, algebra, and even the notorious Algebra 2. Stay tuned and follow the project or contact us to keep in touch with its ultimate incarnation, and we want to let more people learn the intuition behind calculus.